Blackstone Audio presents Big Girl Small by Rachel DeWoskin. 1. When people make you feel small, it means they shrink you down close to nothing, diminish you, make you feel like shit. In fact, small and shit are like equivalent words in English. It makes sense, in a way. Not that small and shit are the same, I mean, but that Americans might think that. Take The Wizard of Oz, for example, an American classic everyone loves more than anything, even though there's a whole munchkin land of embarrassed people, half of them dressed in pink rompers and licking lollipops, even though they're 30 years old. They don't even have names in the credits. It just says at the end, "Munchkins, played by the singer Midgets." Judy Garland apparently loved gay people, was even something of an activist, but she spread rumors about how the Midgets were so raucous, fucking each other all the time and drinking bourbon on the set. People love those stories because it's so much fun to think of tiny people having sex. There was even an urban myth about how one of the dwarfs hanged himself. Everyone said you could see him swinging in the back of the shot. But it turns out it was actually an emu. Right. A bird they got to make the forest look magical. And what, with the 5-inch TVs everyone had in those days, the 2-pixel bird spreading its dirty wings apparently called to mind a dead dwarf. In other words, people wanted it bad enough to believe that's what it was. Magical my ass. I know that small and shit are the same because I'm 16 years old and 3 feet 9 inches tall. Judy Garland was 16, too, when she made Wizard of Oz. But I'm betting she must have felt like she was 9 feet tall, getting to be a movie star and all. I should have known better than to try for stardom myself, because even though my mom sang me Thumbelina every night of my life, she also took me to Saturday Night Live once when we were in New York on a family vacation. And it happened that the night I was there, they had dozens of little people falling off coral risers as one of their skits. My mom almost died of horror, weeping in the audience. Everyone around us thought she was touched, that all those idiots on stage must have been like her other kids. Like they were my beautiful munchkin brothers or something, even though my mom's average size and so are my 2 brothers. They'd even have average lives if only they didn't have me. My mother's idea has always been to try to make me feel close to perfect. But how close can that be, considering I look like she snatched me from some dollhouse? Nothing on Saturday Night Live is ever funny. But the night we went was especially bad. One of the little people even got hurt falling off those risers, but no one thought anything of it, except my mom, who made a point of waiting for an hour after the show was done to ask, was he okay? I was furious, because everyone who walked by us kept saying, "Good show," to me. I would never be in anything of the sort, by the way, because my parents don't believe in circus humiliation. That's what my college essay was going to be on, freak shows and the Hottentot Venus. Most people don't know that much about her, except that she was famous for having a butt so big the Victorians couldn't believe it. So they made her into an attraction people could pay money to stare at and grope. I bet you didn't know, for example, that her name was Sarke, or Little Sarah, or that she even had a name. The little in her name is the cute, endearing version of the word, not the literal little. Or even worse, be little, which by combining be and little means to make fun of. I think I would have included that definition as like the denouement of my essay, after the climax where I planned to mention that after her nightmare carnival life, Little Sarah died at 26 and they preserved her ass on display in a Paris museum. She was orphaned in a commando raid in South Africa. Otherwise, maybe none of those terrible things would have happened to her. I have parents, thankfully, and they always tried to keep me private. I don't mean they hid me in a closet or anything, but they also didn't let people take pictures of me when we traveled or touch me for money. And when people stared, even kids, my parents stared back, unblinking, but friendly-like. The thing is, you can't blame kids for staring. Not only because I'm miniature, but also because I'm a little bit disproportionate. That's what they call it when the fit of your part is in any way off the mainstream chart. Disproportionate. Maybe your arms or legs are too stumpy, or your torso is small and your head is huge. Or maybe you're just you, like Sarke Hottentot. And it's only relative to everyone else that you're disproportionate. Maybe someday they'll think disproportionate dwarf is a rude expression and they'll come up with a nicer way to put it. I think most people know.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.